Well, what a weekend. A win against the Western Force, a 7-point win. That's the highest winning margin in the two clubs' histories against each other. We've also got a 7 on the rise, another 7 returning, and James O'Connor shaves his head for a sensational cause at Spectrum Superstars. Now, if you want to donate to Spectrum Superstars, go to spectrumsuperstars.com and go to the Let Your Mate Know campaign, which James is running about his haircut. Here's all the action from training today. I'm here with Scotty. Now, Scotty, I need to clarify here. How do you pronounce your surname?
Common question, mate. Few Gliss Taller.
Few Gliss Taller. Righto, mate.
Roll off the tongue.
Okay, perfect. Now, last week, debuted for the Rebels and had an outstanding game and back in the starting side this week. You must be thrilled.
Yeah, I'm thrilled. I wasn't overly happy with how I played. I gave away a couple of early penalties, which is not ideal, let my team down a bit. But, you know, that's something I'm working on and just really want to push my case on this week and go for it.
In terms of this week, coming up against people like David Paycock, what's your expectation there?
These games are the games you live and dream for. He's top player in the world, top two players in the world in my position. These are the players that are the benchmark. So these are the ones that I really, really look forward to. So hopefully I bring my A game this week.
Was the whole experience last week what you thought it would be?
Exactly. It did astound me a little bit, just the stadium. I'm used to playing in a big oval stadium, and the stadium was, the crowd was so close. I really enjoyed it. You know, they get to hear the hits. You just feel like you're at it. I feel more at home, and that's pretty awesome after my first game.
In your spare time, in your downtime, yeah. Some kids like to play Xbox. Some people study. In New Zealand, you freedived. So you just found the bottom of the ocean and just hung out down there. Talk me through that.
A couple of boys that I was close with back home. You've got to try it. It's a very relaxing thing to do.
What, just holding your breath for 5 minutes? I'd prefer to do something else, to be honest.
I'm not that good, mate. You know, back in New Zealand, it's the water's quite cold, so you're in and out.
GPS sports, what does that do? Is it a brassiere? Is it a man brassiere? Or has it actually got something to do with high performance?
Well, House, it actually measures the amount of metres that you run every day, mate. Not sure if you actually would have clocked up enough metres for it to actually register for you, but it gives the trainer some input into how fresh we are and how many Ks we've been doing, so yeah, it prevents injury.
Here we are with Gareth Delve as he prepares for battle. Do you strap yourself like this every training session?
Every session. The rest depend on the weather, because it's a bit humid and sweaty up there.
So it's almost...
Try not to sweat on the ball, it's a little technique I picked up.
Oh, really? So that's got nothing to do with injuries, that's just more high fashion and sweat control.
High fashion, mate. This is more about not dropping the ball.
So here with Cooper Vuna, recovering from scap injury, is it?
Yep.
How far away are you, mate? There was something in the paper today saying you're tracking pretty well.
Yeah, I'm going pretty well. Obviously out of the sling, and you know, things are going well in terms of rehab and that, but I think return to play will probably be in a couple of weeks, hopefully.
Good stuff. We certainly wouldn't mind having your strike power out there. How do you think the boys went in their first game?
They obviously went well.
Someone just hit the cameraman with a footy.
The wind was something that we've been aiming for during pre-season and that, and you know, they stuck in pretty hard, and I obviously gave it to them, so it was good.
Crazy, we saw you out there running around. You didn't embarrass yourself, but mood's pretty good at the moment in camp.
Yeah, mate, the guys have trained well during the week. Good mood, so yeah, hopefully it transfers onto Friday night against the Brumbies that have packed Amy.
Mate, tell me, 12 years ago you played against the Lions, and I'm seeing you out there. You're probably still capable of doing it. What are you doing these days to keep fit?
Mate, I'm absolutely no chance of being able to play. Just basically looking after myself, and I lift a couple of times a week with the boys and do a bit of triathlon, and love getting out and doing a little bit of running.
So there you have it, a very happy Rebels camp at the moment. Good to see some of the coaches still getting involved, like former Wallaby Nathan Gray. That's it for another episode, and we'll see you here very soon.